So I'm here with MC Det and Remark, DJ and producer. Right, so we're at Jungle Mania.
Yeah, man.
What to you both makes Jungle Mania so special?
Jungle Mania is very special, Mr. T-Bone, because it's not just only something that's bringing a forward movement for the jungle music, but also is a very strong education of old school jungle music for the young ones that are coming through that don't really know the history of it, and for the new ones that are quite mature and only got into it through the old new stuff. So it's a good foundation for the music. You know, it started in a small club and now it's in a big club. So obviously the movement is working. Do you know what I mean? And it's bringing back and bringing out a lot of DJs that thought that they weren't really, didn't have much to offer anymore. But, you know, they've got a lot of selection and we need that history within the scene. You know what I'm saying? So
I'll tell you what I like. This is like one of the first dances I've been to where a man's playing 100% what I would call jungle. The amount of jungle dances that are promoted as jungle, and I hear drum and bass. And that's a big political thing. Drum and bass, jungle, this, that, this and that. But that is jungle, what's playing in there right now. That's Jungle Mania to me.
So why do you think that jungle has lasted so long and there's still such a big demand for it?
Because it's got soul, it's got energy, it's got a vibe in the music that, you know, I'm not disrespecting drum and bass, but it's got a certain minute that drum and bass doesn't have in it. It's got different musical backgrounds. You got hip hop in it, you got ragga in it, you got soul in it, you got rare groove in it. It ain't steady one, you know, one kind of thing that everybody's on and same kind of routing. Everyone does their own thing in it. It's open. So it's open to more people, different people from different backgrounds and rah, rah, rah.
Ooh. Okay, yeah. Like, you're one half of, you know, one of the most famous jungle DJ and MC combinations.
Yeah.
What would you say is the secret to your and Brocky's success?
Not too far off what Remark just said now, really, about the different sounds within the music. We've always played jungle. New jungle, you know, we've gone through the stages, you know, the stuff that people consider old school jungle. And the music jungle has always progressed, you know. Some people took hold of that sound, just the drum and bass sound, although the jungle sound's always been there. So we've always been stuck on the jungle thing. And, you know, because we've worked with each other on the radio regularly, coming to the events and working live for a crowd, over the years, you know, it's easy to build up the rapport between each other. So I think it's the rapport between us, and I think people like that when they can see something. People have stayed together for so long, you know what I'm saying? I think it's more them than us knowing the reason. The ravers have more the reason than I do. I think maybe, you know, people like a team, you know what I'm saying?
Remark, you being a producer yourself, obviously we've seen MBeat perform tonight, which was, you know, for a long time. We know that Levy's been performing the tune, but he's coming back on the road. What did you think, watching him do his PA and using Ableton Live and stuff like that? Did it inspire you at all?
Ableton and all that, I'm not really in it still, but he's doing his thing, you know what I mean? I think, well, I know no one really plays vinyl no more and all that, but I'm more of, I'm playing CDs and stuff nowadays. I'm not really, all this Ableton stuff and set up mixed business and all that, I'm not in it, man. It's taking everything away from DJ skills and all that, so everybody's a fucking everyone's a top DJ now and rah rah because they can mix with all these timed up things and all that. But yeah, boy, respect to MBeat still, you know what I mean? He's done his thing, done his PA. Bad.
I think maybe it's been a bit misconstrued, because I know in the prep for him prepping it, he was more trying to do a live performance than a DJ set. So he was more trying to like take the tunes in it and chop them up and stuff like that, more than somebody like using Ableton to like mix. I think he was more just playing this stuff and was, you know, because it's harder, because he's only got maybe two tracks with artists to perform, he was trying to, you know, perform some of his tracks and stuff like that, you know?
Yeah.
Right, are you still producing or just exclusively DJing now?
Exclusively DJing, exclusively producing just for myself, 100% dubs. I don't put no tunes out, everything. That's what keeps my DJ sets different from everybody else. I still play old school jungle sets, but like, to be completely honest, I don't know how much times people can play the same old style tunes. Seriously, because I listen radio day in, day out, every single set for the whole day, everyone's playing the same jungle tunes. Like, all right, Jungle's raising again right now. But it's going to disappear quick unless people start making some new tunes. And everybody keeps saying to me, can I remix your tune? Make a fucking new Jungle tune. How do you expect Jungle to move forward if all everyone's hearing is the same tunes remixed 1,000 times? Even the 140. You know, it's just a madness. They need to start. If everyone wants Jungle to raise, you know, as it's on the steps again now, it's coming up again now, then make some tunes, man. Stop begging man to remix their old tunes and all that. Use your own fucking head, use your own heart and make what you want to make. Stop running off other man's ideas and even trying to make a paper off man's other ideas, you know what I mean? That's what I think.
Dep, like, you've been around, obviously, from very much from the beginning of the Jungle. Give us one of your favourite Jungle memories.
Favourite Jungle memories? That's strange. You start off asking me, I've been around for years, you know how many memories I have? Man, I've got so many memories. Good memories or bad memories? What kind of memories
good,
do you want?
Good.
You want good memories?
Positivity you want around here.
Okay. A good Jungle memory. All right, my very first event, I suppose, because it was their first event. It was Jungle Fever in the East End, like Shoreditch on Curtin Road. There was like a warehouse on Curtin Road. And what made it special was that back in the day, people used to spend more on production because it was coming off the back of like Acid Out and Hardcore. And their thing was always very, you know, good, big production. So it was coming off the back of that. So the production was just like, it was, I think it was a Halloween. And the production was crazy. They had all coffins there and, you know, big iron gates and...
I turn street lights down to darkness. I don't want to be the one for start this. Anywhere can't touch this,
respect,
past this.
Brother, anyway.
Where do you get lost, man? This is my fucking... This is my...
Hold tight, Depp. For linking, man.
Get out of here, man. Get out, man.
Bro,
Reggie, man, the Reds, man. This is my... Come on, man. This is Hollywood here. This is Hollywood right here. Do you mind? This ain't the BBC. All right, where was I? Oh, yeah, so it was just Jungle Fever at Curtin Road, really. And the production was really cool. And it was the first time that, like, I'd been able to perform on a stage that had such good production. It was like the stage was done up like a graveyard. And I'll never forget that. That was really good. And Tim Westwood was in, I think he was in Room 2. Yeah.
Wicked. Remark. And you, give us a Jungle memory, man.
You know, yes, it's for real. You know what it is? There's so many. Do you know, I'll tell you one of my big ones was doing a PA at Laserdrome and you actually saved me at last minute, remember?
Oh, you come an MC for it. I remember that, yeah.
Because you know what, after I come off a weekend rush and I started producing, I just disappeared from DJing and all that. I was just producing. But I was putting out tunes. But then when I done the PA, it's like a whole load of people realised, right, you made that tune. Mm. But I remember that, Laserdrome when I done the PA. That was one of my.
Okay, I mean, it's a very, very hard question to ask, but give me some of your favourite Jungle tracks.
Leviticus. Represent.
You know, I couldn't say a favourite, man. There's too many to me.
Not a favourite, but just, you know, throw a couple out there.
General Levy's incredible.
Okay. One that you will always bar for the rewind.
Babylon.
Wicked.
Oh, Babylon. Yeah, Babylon.
Yeah. Babylon.
Cool.